Shit way too formal, y'all know where I'm from too. Stacy Dash, most of these girls ain't got a clue. What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. If you're new to the channel, my name is Will. I'm 20 years old, dropship full-time, been doing this for around 3 years. And this channel is for people trying to get into dropshipping or people that are already dropshipping and trying to maximize their profits. Today's video, I'm gonna be talking about my first ever successful dropshipping store, which was like 2.5 years ago, what you can learn from it, how many orders I did, the sales, the product I sold, and basically what I did wrong. Because from what I believe, if I knew what I know now back then, I would have still had this store pushing sales, pushing numbers, and I probably would have created a tremendous brand. So let's hop right into the video. All right, guys, now here we are, Spring Vibes, my first successful dropshipping store. Now, as you can see, the front has the slogan, where luxury meets the sand. I'm not trying to sell anything. I'm not trying to be salesy. I was really trying to represent a vibe and a brand. As you can see, I'm going for that beach vibe. Next, I have ambassador application. I got this girl in a bikini becoming an ambassador. Then I got the follow us with more girls, hashtag spring vibes on IG. So you can see that I'm giving off that brand vibe, and I'm not like any typical dropshipping store we can tell off right off the bat that, you know, they're dropshipping. Now, I will say that I sold this store, so a lot of the content on here now isn't content that I had on there before. This is the same. I had our philosophy instead of saying about us. I made it say this. It just looks better. And then, like, this image right here is whack. Like, this is, you know, bad graphic. You can tell they made this probably on Canva. They didn't know what they were doing. This is the person, this was added here after I sold the store, so don't think I had this right here. But if you scroll down, these were some of the products I had on the website. Boom, boom, boom. What our customers say. And then I had reviews right here that I just typed out myself, just to make the website look more legitimate and have that social proof and basically get the customers to trust the store. To show you guys that I actually did own this store, because I know there's a lot of bullshit on YouTube, I pulled up my old email that had all the orders going to it. So as you can see, let me go to the next page. You see Spring Vibes, order. These are all orders from this website that I used to own. We can keep going to the next pages. Just keep going and going and going. This store I did around 40K in 3 months, and then I sold it. And I'll show you the actual Shopify Exchange email. Congratulations, the sale of the store, Spring Vibes, boom. As you can see, I sold the store for around $3,000, which was very cheap. And the reason I was only able to sell this store for $3,000 was because after I stopped running it, I just let it sit. So my graph was like this, but after I let it sit, the graph was like this and just kept going, because I sold it 4 months after I stopped running ads to it. So, you know, I was getting a lot of questions like, why isn't this store making sales anymore? Blah, blah, blah. And I kept having to explain, you know, I'm not running ads to this store anymore, and that's why it's not making sales. So that's a tip right there. If you're gonna sell your store, make sure you keep running ads, because if your graph is going up and you're still getting sales, you're gonna be able to sell the store for a lot more. So that's one mistake that I made. That simple mistake that I made cost me probably around 10 to 15 to 20K that I could have made extra on the sale.
I had to switch locations because some dude walked in the room that I was using, and I didn't want to just be talking because I know he was going to work in there. But now that we're sitting down, I'm going to talk about the winning product that I had on that store. So the winning product on the Spring Vibe store was the distance bracelet. Now, if you've been dropshipping for a while now, you've probably seen that product before. It's a very popular product. If you're new to dropshipping, what the distance bracelet is basically, it's a white beaded bracelet. It's two bracelets. One of them is a white beaded bracelet with one black bead, and the other one is a black beaded bracelet with one white bead. I think I said that right. But basically, it's meant for couples, long distance relationship couples, regular couples, whatever. The girl wears one, the guy wears one, that type of concept, right? So that was the only product selling on my store. I tested several. I only test one product at a time. I like to test at least 30 interests per product that I test. I'll spend at most $200 on a product, unless my gut feeling is telling me to, you know, spend a little more. But to keep it short, I sold a distance bracelet. I sold around 4,000 bracelets. I was doing free plus shipping. Now keep in mind, when I was starting out drop shipping, this was 2.5 years ago, or almost 3 years now. When I started out, people were saying drop shipping is dead, free plus shipping is definitely dead. But you gotta learn to cut out all the noise when you're getting into this business. You gotta test it out for yourself and see what works and see what doesn't work. And I'm telling you right now, drop shipping is not dead. It's not even close to dead. And free plus shipping to this day still works, because I have stores doing the free plus shipping business model right now, and they're making sales consistently every single day. Now, with that being said, I was buying the bracelet for like $3 on AliExpress, charging $9.95 shipping on my website, and I sold 4,000 bracelets. I did around 40K in 3 months. On my store, I basically took the AliExpress picture right here, and I put it in Canva. If you don't know what Canva is, it's a free photo editing tool. It lets you create graphics as well. So canva.com, check them out. But I used them, and I plugged my logo on the top left of the image just to make it look more legit. Scroll down, he's still using the same exact product description that I was using. As you can see, these products are made upon demand. Please allow 1 to 3 weeks for arrival. I said that straight up. You don't have to say that straight up. As long as you have a shipping policy that states this or something similar to this, then you're in the green. Bracelet meaning, blah, blah, blah. I had this spaced out better than what he has it now, but this was a big part as well right here. Update, we've been blowing up on social media for this reason. This product is only available for a limited time and supplies will run out very soon. Get yours before it is too late. That urgency right there, I believe, made me tons of sales, because people knew that I only had 100 of these bracelets left, as you can see right here, and they knew that we were blowing up. So if they don't buy it right now, as in right now, like they're on the product page right now, if they don't get it right now, they're not going to get it, because it's gonna be gone. And then I had pictures down here, boom, boom. I had way better pictures. Like I said, when I was controlling this website, it looked way better, but he changed a lot of things. As you can see, he added a price tag to it. When I was running it, it used to say $0, and then it said $29.99. But yeah, that's the product right there. I actually pulled it up on AliExpress for you as well. $1.57 with ePacket, it was like $4. After my first month, or actually like within 2 weeks, when I was selling, you know, a lot of these, at least 50 a day, I contacted the supplier straight on AliExpress. I basically told him, yo, you know, I'm selling at least 50 of these a day. I own a business here in the United States. I want to form a long-term business relationship with you. Can you give me a better price? And I also gave him my WhatsApp. And that's another golden nugget for y'all. When y'all are talking to these AliExpress suppliers, get them off the AliExpress messaging platform. They're gonna take you more seriously if you give them a WhatsApp number or a WeChat. Those are the two main things they use. So make sure you give them the WhatsApp number. I started talking to him on there. He replies way faster on there. He gave me a custom link that I can use for AliExpress, where I would pay basically $2 total, and that's including shipping for my bracelets to the US, because I was getting mainly customers in the US. But yeah, there it is, guys. My first winning product. If you guys have any questions, concerns, make sure you leave those in the comment below. And that's it for this video, guys.
Why this is good?
Yeah. I am a menace. Keep me a wretch, I like tennis. I'm with this shit like I'm Dennis. I started this shit, I'm a finish. Niggas be hating, trying to blemish my image. Who want the smoke? 2 to 3K with the scope. It's